There's a dirty little secret about all these WordPress hosting companies. Out of all the WordPress hosting companies out there, only 3 are recommended by WordPress themselves. And we're gonna look at the top 10 hosting companies and go over the pros and cons of every single hosting company one by one. And by the end of this video, you'll know exactly which hosting company is right for you. As a bonus, I have the hookup. I have special discounted pricing for all these hosting companies that you can only get right here. And I'm gonna be sharing that with you at the end of this video as well. But let's get started first with SiteGround. And one of the big pros about SiteGround is it's extremely easy to set up. I even did a video talking about how you can set up a WordPress website using SiteGround in just 4 minutes. They're also one of the 3 different hosting companies that are actually recommended by WordPress. And they also have very affordable pricing, but they are not the cheapest hosting company out there. Hostinger, which I'll be talking about later in this video, is actually the cheapest hosting company out there and actually pretty decent. So make sure you stay tuned for Hostinger. But going back to SiteGround, SiteGround is extremely reliable. They have over 99.99% uptime, and they have extremely fast servers, and you get a free SSL certificate, which basically allows your site to be more secure. But there are some cons for SiteGround. One of the first cons is, even though it's pretty affordable priced, it's still mid-tier pricing. As I mentioned, there are some hosting companies that are cheaper. Another con with SiteGround is there are plan limits. If you're planning to host a ton of videos on your website or really large images and a lot of images at that, SiteGround might not be the best option for you. Though they do have gigabytes and gigabytes of storage for 99% of the people out there, it should be plenty of storage, but this is something you should keep in mind. Next up is Bluehost. And Bluehost is one of the most popular WordPress hosting sites out there. It's also the 2nd of the 3 different hosting companies that are recommended by WordPress. They're also one of the most trusted companies out there, which brings us to our first con with them. And this is true about all different hosting platforms, but the way that they became so popular and so trusted is they were one of the first ones to have an affiliate program. An affiliate program is basically where people talk about hosting companies in exchange for getting a kickback when people sign up for that hosting company. And this isn't necessarily a bad thing, but as someone that's been using Bluehost for a number of years now, their service has gotten a lot slower. And honestly, I think for what you get right now, it's overpriced. And now before we move on to the next platform, GoDaddy, I want to tell you a little secret, because all these hosting companies offer affiliate programs. And part of the reason I'm able to give you the hookup and give you such a good discount is I signed up as an affiliate for all these different programs so that I could make this video and make it as unbiased as possible. But let's talk about GoDaddy. And my recommendation is do not use GoDaddy no matter what. They're okay for buying a domain name, but they're not even the cheapest one for buying a domain name. And they spend a ton of money on advertising. And the way that they're able to make that money back on all the money they spend on advertising is by having higher prices and tricking people into buying a domain name and then adding on hosting and adding on other features that you just don't need. Do not go with GoDaddy. They are overpriced and they just do not offer a high quality service when it comes to hosting your website. A2 Hosting is one of the fastest hosting providers out there. Basically meaning when people go to your website, it's gonna load up extremely fast. But on the downside, they have really poor uptime. And uptime basically means how often people can actually visit your site. Now keep in mind, no hosting company has 100% uptime, but most of them have 99.99% uptime, meaning just about anytime someone tries to go to your website, they're gonna be able to go there. But A2 Hosting has one of the lowest uptime percentages out there. And they actually got hacked a few years ago. And from what I've heard, it seems like they still haven't fully recovered from some of that hack. So be careful with A2 Hosting, but it still has like 99.96% uptime and it's an extremely fast hosting provider. HostGator is another extremely popular hosting platform out there. Now, HostGator is actually owned by the same company as Bluehost, but Bluehost is actually recommended by WordPress themselves. So in my opinion, there's really not that big of a difference between these two. Sometimes HostGator is a little bit cheaper and sometimes Bluehost is a little bit cheaper. You can check the prices in the description down below, but out of these two, I would probably go with Bluehost over HostGator. Now there's still one company that's recommended by WordPress we haven't talked about, and I still need to talk about the cheapest hosting company out there. But first let's talk about WP Engine. And WP Engine is fast. It's reliable. It's probably the best hosting company out there, but as a con, it's 10 times the price of every other hosting company out there. So I would not personally recommend this hosting company for most people. But if you have a website that needs really high uptime, that needs to be the fastest possible, this could be a good option. But most other hosting companies have higher end plans that are just as good as WP Engine for a fraction of the price. Now, before we get to Hostinger, InMotion is another popular hosting company, but I don't really see any big pros with them. They do have good speed, good uptime, they're pretty reliable, but they're still more expensive than a lot of the other hosting platforms out there. Finally, let's talk about Hostinger. And the big pro with them is they are cheap. They are really, really cheap. They have plans that start at 99 cents a month, which is the cheapest out there. Now, a con with them is if you want that really cheap plan, you gotta sign up for 4 years. So it's gonna cost you about $48. But even still, that's really inexpensive. Another pro is it's actually fast. You would think for that low of a price that you would get junk service, but it's actually really fast. But as a con, if you start getting a lot of traffic to your website, it does slow down very quickly. They do have higher tier plans that you can always upgrade to, but keep in mind, if you're paying 99 cents a month, you're not gonna be able to have a website that gets a lot of traffic. They're gonna throttle your bandwidth, meaning they're not gonna let people come in, look at your website, and give you a fast connection. They also don't have phone support. So if your website is something very important to you and you wanna be able to call someone and get on the phone if you have an issue, Hostinger might not be the best option. They do have some chat support, so that is always an option if you run into issues with your website. But again, for me personally, I would not host my website with Hostinger. Doesn't mean it's a bad option. I'm just at the point now where I want to pay a little bit more to make sure that my website is actually up and running correctly. If you're really tight on cash, this is a great option. And finally, we have DreamHost. And DreamHost is the last of the three different hosting platforms that are recommended by WordPress. But honestly, I don't see any advantage with DreamHost. They're more expensive than a lot of the other platforms. They're also slower and less reliable. And finally, let's talk about the winner. What is the best WordPress hosting website out there? Well, the answer is, it depends on what you're looking for. If you're looking for the fastest hosts out there, then A2 Hosting might be a good option. If you're looking for the most reliable hosting company and you're willing to pay for it, WP Engine might be a good option. If you're on a budget and you want the cheapest hosting, then Hostinger is a really good option. But in my opinion, the best hosting company out there and where you should host your WordPress website is SiteGround. SiteGround is a good price, it's reliable, they got phone support, and it's personally what I use and recommend. And I have the hookup with SiteGround. I have hugely discounted prices. You can click on the links down below to see the cheapest prices you can find around. In fact, with all these hosting companies, I tried to negotiate the best possible price I can, and you can find out the discounted pricing in the links down below. I personally don't care which one you go with. Go with the one that is best for you. But if you use my links down in the description, I'm gonna throw in, as a bonus for using my links, a complete tutorial on WordPress and WooCommerce completely for free. So click on the links down in the description, sign up for a hosting platform, create your first website today. Creating my first website was one of the best things I've ever done. And right now is the perfect time for you to start your website. So click on the links, sign up, start your website today, and remember to enjoy the journey. Thanks for watching.